On January 1st, 1989, the left-wing theatre group, Jananati Manch or People's Theatre Front, also known as Janam, was staging a play in the Jandapur region of India's capital, New Delhi. The play, Halla Bol, was based on a strike in the area a few years ago and was being staged ahead of the local body polls. Suddenly, goons associated with the ruling Indian National Congress attacked the gathering. Two people died in the attack. A worker, Ram Bahadur, died almost immediately. And the next day, on January 2nd, Safdar Hashmi, one of India's most iconic cultural activists, succumbed to his injuries. In this episode of Around the World in 8 Minutes, we pay homage to the memory of Safdar and look at other struggles from across the world. Stay tuned. Safdar Hashmi not only founded the Jananati Manch or Janam, but also revolutionized political theatre in India. Janam was in the forefront of taking theatre to the people, especially the working class, and using it as a powerful political tool. Through a number of iconic plays, many of which were exclusively staged in working class areas, Janam and Safdar exposed the brutality of the capitalist system and the barbarity of the Indian ruling class and political elite. A dedicated communist and a member of the Communist Party of India Marxist, Safdar and Janam performed plays on the exploitation of workers and their resistance, the issues faced by farmers, the oppression of women and their fight back, among other issues. Following his death on January 2, 1989, Janam returned to the same area and performed the same play on January 4th, one of the most inspiring instances of resistance in the century. Safdar's memory is preserved today through Janam and other organizations, which continue his struggle for a just society. On January 1st this year, on the anniversary of the brutal attack, cultural and political activists and hundreds of workers gathered to honour Safdar, his struggle and the enduring spirit of resistance that he symbolised. Here are some scenes from the gathering.
स्वर्ग तो उतार ला जमीन पर तू जिंदा है। भी है आग पेट की, बुरे हैं दिल के दाग, ये न दब सकेंगे एक दिन बनेंगे इंकलाब, ये बुरी है आग पेट की, बुरे हैं दिल के दाग, ये न दब सकेंगे एक दिन बनेंगे इंकलाब, ये
गिरेंगे जुल्म के महल, बनेंगे फिर नवीन घर,
अगर कहीं है स्वर्ग तो उतार ला जमीन पर, तू जिंदा है जिंदगी की जीत में यकीन कर, अगर कहीं है स्वर्ग तो उतार ला जमीन पर, तू जिंदा है जिंदगी की जीत में यकीन कर, अगर कहीं है स्वर्ग तो उतार ला जमीन पर, तू जिंदा है।
We now go to Germany, where the cabin crew of the German budget airlines, German Wings, a subsidiary of Lufthansa, went on a three-day strike from December 30th to January 1st. They were protesting the deadlock over collective bargaining for better pay and working conditions for over 22,000 employees. The call for the strike was given by the UFO Labour Union. The UFO has been demanding higher wages, particularly for entry-level jobs, as well as better access to secure long-term contracts. The union also warned authorities of further strike actions if the deadlock over the bargaining over collective agreement continues. The UFO also led a strike earlier in November. While airline authorities initially remained unwilling to engage and even questioned the credibility of the union, they were finally forced to come to the bargaining table. We now head to Palestine, where December 31st marked 100 days since Palestinian administrative detainee Ahmad Zahran went on a hunger strike demanding his release. 42-year-old Zahran is being held without charge or trial and was recently hospitalized after his health deteriorated. He has already lost 30 kilos. Zahran's current detention began in February. In June, he had launched a hunger strike which went on for 39 days. He ended it only after Israeli authorities promised that his term of administrative detention would not be renewed once it ended in October. However, they broke this promise and Zahran launched another hunger strike which continues. Administrative detention is a brutal tool used by Israelis to hold Palestinians in detention for extended periods of time. Currently, more than 500 Palestinians are being held in administrative detention, a colonial practice which is also a violation of Geneva Convention laws. And finally, for weeks, resistance has been mounting in India and among the Indians abroad against the Divisive Citizenship Amendment Act, which discriminates based on religion. In India, the government has faced the full might of people's resistance, and the Indian diaspora too has come out in full strength in solidarity with them. Here are some scenes from protests in Germany.
Fascism down, 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 down. Fascism down, down,
down, down, down, down.
Islamophobia 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 down, down,
down, down, down.
That's all we have for this episode of Around the World in 8 Minutes. To know more about these stories, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org and follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Thanks for watching.